Since 2009, thousands of entrepreneurs entered the Shark Tank to pitch their businesses. And some of these businesses became successful investments that made their entrepreneurs and investors millions in profit.
I'll make you a millionaire within a year.
But there can only be one most successful business in Shark Tank history. This is where David and Randy enter the tank, pitching their company Bombas, an athletic sock company. Randy and David start their company in 2013 after they learned that socks are the most requested clothing item in homeless shelters. They established the brand's mission to donate one pair of socks for every pair purchased by the customer. This will become very important later. They start crowdfunding for the business on Indiegogo and raised $140,000. They enter the Shark Tank asking for $200,000 for 5% for their company. Robert asked an important question.
Andy, I'm a big runner. I gotta tell you, specialty sports socks are everywhere. Mm-hmm. How are you different?
They told him they take the qualities of high-priced socks and put them at a $9 price point, which was a good answer. But it wasn't the right answer. Kevin didn't like their business model of giving a sock away for every pair bought.
Question philosophically about this idea of giving something away every time you sell. You have to double your sales to give me the equivalent returns that I get from a company that's not doing the same.
He later would realize he was very wrong.
Could I be more sorry?
The entrepreneurs informed the Sharks they made $450,000 in 9 months, and they have a 54% profit margin, which piques the Sharks' interest. Mark asked an interesting question.
And what is your month-to-month growth?
And their answer almost cost them the entire deal.
So our month-to-month growth has plateaued this year.
But they try to recover by informing them they plateaued because they spend their time raising capital. And they have raised $900,000 in a $4 million evaluation. This is where Kevin went out. If you know why Kevin went out, like this video. If you don't subscribe because we've got more videos on Shark Tank.
Guys, a $4 million valuation in a total commodity of socks is ludicrous. And I think reality will strike because you guys are still sock cockroaches. You're nowhere. You have no market share yet. You have no retail exposure.
You could have said that to the guy
I think
who started
if you can raise money
any company.
You got to start somewhere.
If any of these sharks give you money at that valuation, I will forbid it. It's ridiculous. I'm out.
Robert finds it challenging in determining whether or not it will work as a standalone online business for the long time or if it's a supplementary. Lori hates it when the entrepreneurs say they want to use the money to hire in people. She thinks the two of them should be doing everything they can to run it themselves at this point, and they both went out. Mark didn't like it when they say they plateaued when they should be rising at 9 months, so he went out, which left the guys with only Damon. He played them well by asking them to offer him a better deal than offering one himself. They offered 10% of the business for the $200,000, and he knew he got them. They closed the deal at 17.5%.
I'm going to finance the inventory, $200,000 for 17.5%. That's it.
You have a deal.
We'll take it.
So, why this business? How does a socks company become the most profitable business in Shark Tank history, making over $300 million? It lies in their business model. Millennials are the most socially conscious generation. So, buying a sock is not just buying a sock. Eating chicken nuggets is not just eating chicken nuggets. And drinking beer is not just drinking beer. The consumer wants something that aligns with their values and supports their ideals. And Bombas' one sock giveaway to a homeless shelter for every socks purchased make them not only a sock company, but an outlet to show how generous, socially conscious, and morally righteous their consumers are just by buying a sock. They also didn't alienate half of potential customers by picking homelessness as their cause because everyone wants to help homeless people. And that is what Kevin failed to see.
But I have a question philosophically about this idea of giving something away every time you sell. You have to double your sales to give me the equivalent returns that I get from a company that's not doing the same thing.
Or your sales double because of the goodwill that you're putting out there.
The other factor that made them successful is Damon's advice on Beyond the Tank.
So now we've had a huge, struggle with deciding whether we go to retail or not.
I think that you're trying to really understand how to expand, but every time you go to retail, you get further away from the money. You know, you go out and you want to sell the sock. You normally would make this sock for, $5, and you sell it to your end customer for $20, argument's sake. Now you sell it to the store at $10. So now your margin is cut in half, number one. Then you have to pay for hanging costs. And then after 4 weeks, if they don't sell it, they reduce it 10%. Then 6 weeks, they reduce it 20%. Right. They're coming to you saying, write me a check for $1 million.
Right?
So all of a sudden, you get a bill from a retailer. It can put you out of business.
This advice is what kept them from bankruptcy, in my opinion. As a small business, the worst thing you could do to your business is going to large retail stores cutting your revenue in half. It might work for everyday items like soap or cooking ingredients. But for a specialty item like Bombas, the worst place is in retail store. Because Bombas is not a socks company. It's a feel-good-about-yourself company. And putting their product next to another cheaper socks without their message would have destroyed their business. With this advice, Damon saved their company. Nowadays, Bombas is still in business, diversifying their product line to t-shirts, underwear, and slippers so that their consumers could display their generosity easily by wearing a t-shirt rather than socks. And they have a sale of over $200 million, becoming the most profitable business in Shark Tank history.
Done over $225 million in revenue and donated over 30 million pairs of socks to those in need.
Thank you for watching this far. Subscribe to this channel for more videos like this.